As far as who the water belongs to, that's a difficult question for me to answer. But I can certainly say that it doesn't belong to me, and it doesn't belong to my family. Maybe the water belongs to the fish. Maybe the water even belongs to the future.
Tributaries are important to a river because they're just like your arteries, your appendages, arm and leg. They're not a separate entity from the river system. And they're critical, especially in large river systems, because they provide a diversity of other habitat types for invertebrate life or fish life at different seasons. Think of the river during the winter time when it's severely icing, it's a hostile environment, or during the big flood events. So fish like the rainbow trout, brown trout, Yellowstone cutthroat trout, mountain whitefish all move out of the river into the tributaries to spawn to rear their young. The young return then to the river when they're old enough to survive in the more difficult conditions presented by the river.
It's vital. The cutthroat trout are genetically programmed to spawn in the tributaries. They must spawn in the tributaries.
A lot of people make the mistake of thinking it's just about a trout. It's just about a target. It's a recreational entity. It's like bowling or something. And it really isn't. It all expresses the health of our earth, right? If we can't be good enough stewards or managers to keep healthy trout populations in our rivers or healthy rivers, then we're not going to do a very good job of taking care of each other either. And in the long run, our human fate is tied to the fate of trout or ospreys or eagles or otters. It's really no different. We tend to separate ourselves, distance ourselves from the natural world, thinking that we're not part of that anymore. But we are. Our fate is tied to the fate of the rivers.